He's a force of nature.
He's the man. He's a really cool guy.
The guy oozes charisma.
He's bold. Very, very bold.
He's a lot of fun.
Wonderful laugh.
Contagious enthusiasm.
Of enormous intellect, but without any airs.
He's somebody who really connects to people.
A deep thinker.
Thoughtful, reflective.
A really rigorous attention to standards.
He's a truly global personality.
Always trying to look at the big picture.
He was delighted that Max became our president because I think he has a vision of really taking, advancing it. He's going to take it further and faster.
When I think of the ancient Greeks and Praxis, I think of Max. I don't think of him as ancient, but I think his Greek blood infuses him with a knowledge of what it takes to rebuild education in this country.
He's a European born and bred. On the other hand, he's quintessentially American in his pragmatism, in his optimism, and his entrepreneurialism. Max's mind is a fusion of two usually separate pathways, one the humanities, and then the other side, the award-winning electronic engineer.
Max is an engineer who is always problem-solving. Sometimes when you haven't even formulated what the problem is, Max is thinking about what can be.
In 1995, Max put together an interdisciplinary team that submitted a proposal for an engineering research center to the National Science Foundation, and we won it.
And to understand the potential of the visual and the narrative language of cinema for new digital media systems was incredibly prescient.
And for the School of Engineering, it was like walking on cloud nine. It was so big. He raised hundreds of millions of dollars in a very short time. He was able to close with Andrew Viterbi, the naming gift for the School of Engineering.
It was a no-brainer to entrust my name to Max Nikias. I spotted him as a leader who would go far, and I was right.
Dr. Nikias launched quite an initiative to bring interdisciplinary studies to the University of Southern California, creating also professorships in this field, and I think that's one of the great achievements.
Max has played an absolutely critical role in helping us develop the Women in Science and Engineering program so that it's now a nationally recognized template for how to make progress on, in particular, hiring women in science and engineering. Without his incredibly strong support and enthusiasm, the program would not be as successful as it is today.
Max has been an advocate for industry partnerships, establishing the kinds of collaborations that allow it to be a win-win for industry, for the student, and for the school.
I think it's amazing that he teaches a freshman seminar focused on, you know, classical Greek arts.
He understands that a country like this needs all the different disciplines, including art.
How unusual is it for an engineer to see the value of art? I can't wait to see SC's art students grow. It's going to be so much fun.
Visions and Voices was the brainchild of then Provost Nikias, really underscoring his belief that the arts and humanities are an essential part of any university.
I saw Stephen Hawking talk about black holes. I saw Nellie Portman talk about microfinancing in third world countries. I've seen exhibits on the Beatles.
And by the end of the first year, you know, 18,000 students had turned out.
Max determined that what was then called the Shoa Foundation should be part of the university. The entire institute of the Shoa Foundation was brought lock, stock, and barrel to become a part of the university. Max's ability to make things work enabled that deal to be made.
He is the person who can get you to do things for him, and you also felt that it's your own idea.
I think it was Max's leadership, Max's dedication, that put the university hospital, the Keck School, and the health science campus where it is today.
He has such a warm personality, such a sincere listener, but yet also a tough negotiator. And he did a wonderful job in bringing the two hospitals to USC.
It's essential in the global marketplace in which we live to have a university that has a global reach. USC has to see itself, and I think it will even more clearly under the leadership of Max Nikias, because of his own background, see itself as a participant in world events.
He's a global personality and very fittingly president of a global university.
Max brings innovation in and of itself. Max thinks outside of the envelope. And that's what this university and any great university needs at this time in world history and in American history.
It takes a lot of energy, a lot of passion. I mean, you're out every night. Max has that energy. He has the passion.
I don't know when he sleeps. And his wife is always there supporting him too. Nikki, she's amazing. She's been great.
She's bright and sparkly just like Max is. The notion of them working together to build USC to something even bigger is clearly there. And I have to imagine that those who selected Max knew that they got a lot more than just Max.
Max is a very warm individual, very approachable, very compassionate.
He cares to help people way beyond the call of duty.
His energy, his excitement for where we're going in this university, well, I'd follow him anywhere.
He is the right man at the right time for USC to bring USC's future into new heights.
One of his cornerstones is his vision. But more so to that is his ability to execute. Lots of people have ideas. Very few people can also see the plan on how to execute to make those ideas come to life.
He wants USC to move up into the small elite group of schools, and he has a plan. Max is reaching for the stars.
Max is one of those people who leads so well that he never has to look over his shoulder to see if anybody's following him.
This is a man at home in science and the humanities, at home in any number of the continents, at home in the ancient world, at home in the modern world, at home in the future.
I kind of feel like he's at the 50-yard line and he's going to get the ball into the end zone in the next three downs.
The Destined Reign of Troy is an intellectual community that has achieved undisputed elite status at the very epicenter of global influence. When you are there, there is no doubt, there is no argument, there is no question, you belong within the pantheon of world-class universities. And there is no limit on the impact USC is able to make upon the world. All this is the great adventure. All this is the great journey. All this is the way forward to the destined reign of Troy.